Hello everyone and welcome back to the 3T Path channel. My name is Giri Daridas and today I want to read you a beautiful verse from the Bhagavad Gita which brings to us one of the most important aspects of yoga, which is equanimity, which is being focused and stable with the ups and downs of life, where we learn that there's actually no good or bad, but that we can remain with inner peace throughout life. So let me read you this first. I'll read first the Sanskrit and then the translation, and then we'll talk about it a little more. So this is verse 214, chapter 2, verse 14 of the Bhagavad Gita. Matra sparshas tu kunteya sitoshna sukadukadam agamapayino nityas tam stitik shashva bharata. Translation. O son of Kunti, which is Arjuna, the non-permanent appearance of happiness and distress and their disappearance in due course, or like the appearance and disappearance of winter and summer seasons. They arise from sense perception, O sign of Bharata, and one must learn to tolerate them without being disturbed. So this is a beautiful verse from the Bhagavad Gita, and it brings to us this idea that we cannot remain with our senses stuck to reality. Our happiness cannot be correlated with the outside events of reality. If it's cold, if it's too hot, if you have money, if you don't have money, you got a job, you were fired, you have a good relationship, the relationship ended, you're healthy, you're sick. These things, these changes, the Bhagavad Gita changes, we have to learn to become detached from them and learn to live our inner life. So the equanimity. It's a subject that comes from the beginning to the end of Bhagavad Gita. And how do you get this equanimity? Well, by focusing your mind on something other than external material reality. You focus on your internal reaction to reality. Do you see? In Bhagavad Gita, what we want to do is we want to be focused on how we react to reality. And that reaction is the same. That's why it's equanimity, one reaction to reality. That reaction is based on two important topics of the Bhagavad Gita, dharma, bhakti, the two major aspects, major pillars of the Bhagavad Gita of yoga practice. So first, dharma. What does that mean? That you're focused on doing your part, on living your reality, your life, your response to reality. So who are you? How am I going to it depends how you react to reality depends on who you are, your dharma. For example, there's a crime and there's an active police officer. So he has one way of reacting to their crime, which is to, you know, do whatever police men and police women do, you know, just to stop the criminal, you know, report this, you know, control and protect civilians, etc. So he has one dharma. As a walking by citizen, your dharma is just maybe just to protect yourself, to run and hide, or if you can, maybe to help someone next to you. Okay, or if you're a mother with a small child, your dharma is just to protect your child. So the same reality, different people have different dharmas and different ways to react. So how they react to that scene is according to their dharma. So one focus, what is my dharma? And secondly, on a higher level, for those who are spiritually activated, who are yogis, then there's bhakti, devotion. So you react to reality according to your dharma in devotion, in bhakti, knowing that whatever you're doing as an offering to Krishna. That's a basic concept of the Bhagavad Gita. So that is one reaction. You see, dharma and bhakti is one, the same reaction, no matter what the situation. That's why there's no good or bad. Whatever is happening, good or bad, is it rain, shine, healthy, sick, again, you know, employed, you got fired, whatever is going on, I still have one focus, Dharma and Bhakti. In any situation, I have one response. My response according to my Dharma and in the mood of Bhakti, of devotion, of love of Krishna, of taking shelter of God. You see? And so my consciousness is no longer connected to the ups and downs of external reality, because I'm focused on analyzing how well I am adjusting to reality according to my Dharma and Bhakti. Do you see? That's my metric. That's the metric I'm using. That's what's defining my happiness, is how well I am doing in Dharma and Bhakti, which is entirely up to me and no longer out of my hands. You see the huge difference. And that's why yoga gives you this huge, well, it's not even comparable, just, you know, it's a completely different reality, a way of living life, because now you're no longer dependent on things outside your control. If you're focused on good or bad, cold, oh, it's too cold, no, it's hot, okay, you know, the economy is this, and my money in the bank, you're focused on things beyond your control. And therefore, you're guaranteed to be in anxiety, frustration, fear, and a whole bunch of other horrible feelings, because it's not in your control. Your life is not in your control. But as a yogi, what you do is you bring control over, because now you're focused on how you're reacting to reality. It's only up to me if I behave according to my nature, my Dharma. It's only up to me if I am in bhakti or not. And when I am doing my Dharma and when I am in bhakti, naturally you feel really good. The natural result of living a purposeful life in devotion is joy. It's unavoidable. It's been explained by wise people from all over the world throughout history. And I've experienced it, my students experience it, maybe you're experiencing it. It's really easy, and everybody can verify that this is a fact. If you live a life based on purpose and devotion, you're guaranteed a ever higher state of consciousness, bliss, well-being, inner peace, because it just, that's what the soul wants. That is the nature of the soul. You've reached like the very basis of what the soul desires and needs. And so you feel joy from it. You feel whole. So that's the trick. It's a beautiful verse from the Bhagavad Gita. Not to be dependent. There are no good and bad things, but only how you react to them. And how you react to them is only up to you. As long as you do it in Dharma and Bhakti, you'll feel bliss, you'll feel contentment, you'll feel the very best you can feel. If you have any questions, please leave below. I'd love to hear from you. And please don't forget to like and subscribe. It's very important for a small channel like this. And your support is very, very much welcome. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful day with lots of peace and lots of love.